Major General Gershon HaKohen, deputy director of this drill, Fatal Arrow drill, thank you very much for taking your time inside, in the middle of your drill. First of all, and thanks for this exclusive interview, what's your first assessment of the drill?
The most important thing here is our determination. Once the decision was made, it was necessary to face the health restrictions caused by coronavirus. We were afraid that the reservists would not want to come, considering that this puts them in danger. But their turnout was total in all divisions of command. And I can assure you that we respected the health rules. But beyond that, they understood that the IDF is forced to maintain a very high degree of preparation, given all the scenarios that we may encounter on the ground.
Why is IDF using this its entire offensive capability in this drill?
Modern warfare is a war where technological aspect is crucial. It is impossible to continue as we did in the past, where everyone comes up with their own strategy. It must be like a concert. If you don't play in the rhythm of the rest of the orchestra, you can't or you don't know how to fit into the score. Harmonization of army corps and chains of command is the key to operational success. This is exactly what the chief of staff has been working on since taking office.
Is this your definition of an offensive drill?
Above all, since its creation, and especially since the War of Independence of 1948, IDF has been an offensive army. Why are we talking about an army for the defense of Israel? This is because we only go to war to defend our interests. But we must always shift the fighting into enemy territory, and especially when the enemy is Hezbollah in Lebanon, but also in Syria, when places like Metula and Shlomi are located on the border, our best defense is attack, and the IDF, as it is used to, trains in offensive operations.
The chief of staff, Aviv Kochavi, said that 60% of enemy infrastructure cannot be destroyed without ground operations. But at the same time, while the IDF is training, Hezbollah is making war across the region.
The composition and the harmony of the forces is the secret of success. But I prefer not to go into details. It is obvious that all army corps are employed in this exercise. The secret is not the use of this or that combat helicopter. The secret is the combination of all these forces. We send a message to all those who try to deny the concrete threat of Hezbollah and who speak of the movement as a simple terrorist threat. Hezbollah poses a concrete threat to Israel, has more than 100,000 rockets threatening our civilian population. Take the example of Operation Protective Edge in 2014 and the last wars waged by the United States over the past 10 years. When the infantry is not present in enemy territory, the operational results are insufficient with the use of the Air Force.
You're also talking about the lessons we learned from the Second Lebanon War in 2006. Be ready, always be in alert.
You have to be able to actively operate in enemy territory, and above all, to quickly achieve the goals we have set for ourselves. You have to think about the composition of the forces on the ground, but also the way in which the chains of command operate with each other, to see how the infantry, the Air Force, and other army corps under the command of the General Staff, have demonstrated our power, how this harmony of forces maintains a superiority and a quality that we did not have in the past.
Thank you very much, Major General Gershon HaKohen, director of this Fatal Arrow drill, for taking your time to give us this exclusive interview.
Thank you. We're tired, but strong.